Let's first start off with functions of zinc. What are some of the ways that zinc is critical? What are some of its very, very important functions? I'm trying to get my feet up so I can say hello to you guys. So we got a slow internet tonight. So again, functions. Functions of zinc. Now, zinc is critical. It plays a role in a couple of hundred different functions that we know of. Some of those functions are the regulation of the structure and shape of different proteins in your body. Some of those are functions in creating tissue, so creating different types of proteins, creating the structure of those proteins. Some of those functions have to do with running what I like to call the molecular motors of your internal body. Remember, if you've ever done one of these DNA tests like 23andMe and some of these other brands, when they're checking those genes, think of each gene as like a unique motor, and that each unique motor has a different function, but each unique motor or gene also has a key to start the motor, right? Those keys in biochemistry, we call those coenzymes, meaning that they are necessary for the enzyme to function. The gene produces the enzyme. So without zinc, zinc is a car key, so to speak, or a motor key, for several of these different very, very important enzymes and proteins that your body produces to bring about different functions. So we know of more than 200 different functions for zinc. Some of them are critical. So we'll put a little 200 right here. One of the big ones is in immune regulation. This is why you'll hear with a cold or a flu, you'll see a lot of the immune formulas, the supplemental formulas that are being sold on the market, a lot of them contain zinc in them. The reason being, zinc is very, very important for your immune cells to mature. It's very important for them to produce certain chemicals that help you fight off viruses and bacteria and fungus and parasites. So zinc, very, very critical for immune function and immune regulation. Another function of zinc that's very, very crucial is healing and repair. Your body needs zinc. Remember, your body's constantly healing and repairing. It's constantly breaking down old tissue so that you can replace it with new tissue. That process of healing and repair is very critical. If you've ever had skin cells slough off, and you have, right? Those are cells that are dead, that are dying, that are sloughing off. Basically, your body is getting rid of those old cells so that you can repair and bring in new cells. Well, that happens in your skin. It happens in your intestines. It happens in your brain. It happens in your liver, your spleen, your kidney, and all of your organs. So remember, healing and repair is very, very crucial. Zinc is important for creating a lot of those proteins that create the structure or the backbone of your collagen, your soft tissue, your muscle tissue, etc. So in the healing and repair process, zinc is one of the most important nutrients we have. It's necessary for the structure of a number of different proteins. So there's an old saying in biochemistry, and that is structure dictates function. Square tires obviously don't roll. So zinc plays a role in folding the different proteins in your body molecularly, the very small microscopic proteins. It helps your body fold them into the right shape so that they work and they do their job properly. Now, another function of zinc is in DNA. It is necessary to replicate and produce new DNA. So we talk about healing and repair. You need new DNA to do that as well. But you need new DNA to make new cells overall. So new cell regeneration, new cell formation requires the replication of DNA, and you need zinc to make DNA. It's necessary for DNA synthesis. The other is the growth and development of tissues. So we're running low on the board here. Growth and development. And this is ever more critical in babies and in really developing babies, when their bodies are developing in the womb. Zinc deficiency can cause a lot of problems if a pregnant mother is not getting adequate zinc. The baby can be born with a lower IQ. The baby can be born at low birth weight. There can be a lot of defects that occur as a result of zinc deficiency. So growth and development of a number of different tissues, your skin, your muscles, your joints, all important. Zinc plays a role as well in sperm health. For men And sperm health, your sperm motility, your sperm speed, your sperm function, your sperm viability depends on zinc. Zinc's very, very important preserving and protecting the sperm, but also in creating the tail of the sperm, that tail that whips them up so that they can swim adequately, otherwise they don't make it to their target. So sperm health, very, very critical function of zinc. And then zinc also serves as an antioxidant system. So antioxidants. There's actually a system in your body called SOD. That stands for superoxide dismutase. It's a very, very potent enzyme protein that helps to regulate detoxification. It helps to regulate how well your antioxidant systems are working. And zinc is, again, is what starts that motor. So those are the main functions of zinc. We'll get into a little bit more here tonight.
Hey, don't forget to check out the rest of the series right here. Make sure you hit subscribe below. And as always, thanks for tuning in.